In this module, we're going to talk about the StorSimple virtual appliances or actual appliances that we can package and have on-premises in order for us to facilitate data movement, particularly around like business continuity or disaster recovery type scenarios for the storage. And if we take a step back, I'll show you on a diagram here really quick what we're talking about. So in our world that exists today in the enterprise, we basically have, over here's our on-prem. And here's Azure. And this is primarily around a storage type conversation. But over here we have, you know, our end users who want to access files. Let's use files for an example. They're going to access some data. Now, we deploy this device over here, this StorSimple device. And really what that does, over here, we actually have a storage account, right, in Azure. We all know what storage accounts are. And the interesting thing about Azure is that when we do that, we actually store these in what's called LRS by default, and we can actually extend it. And LRS stands for locally redundant storage. So basically, we have three copies of whatever data that we put there. In case there's any kind of hardware failure or anything inside of Azure, we have LRS. We also have GRS, and we have more extended ones. But GRS allows us to geo-replicate, so we would, you know, make another copy of this in a different region, right? So if this was the East Coast, maybe we could replicate that to the West Coast. So point is, we have a really highly available, highly redundant storage system inside Azure that's really great at storing stuff. But the problem is it's in the cloud. And the problem is the people here in this case are actually on premises and they need to access these things really fast. I mean, we're talking about, we don't want a second or two delay every time we open a Word document or open something that we're working in this business app. And so that's where StorSimple comes in. And StorSimple really is just a hardware device that you can think of it kind of like a cache. So it has a bunch of hard disks in it. And it's just going to basically maintain this, we'll call it synchronization, but that's really what it is. It's basically you establish policies up here. And those policies will dictate what stays on this device hot. So this would be hot stuff because people are accessing it and they want it fast. And what goes cold, which will go up to Azure. Right? So they've done some studies and basically said that, you know, of all the documents that people access in an enterprise, it's something like 10 to 20% is the actual hot, like what they're actually using of what is produced. Like 80% of this stuff is accessed infrequently or not very often, right? So in that case, we have a single point of failure here. If we're on-prem, we actually have to back up all that data, right? So we don't want to lose that data because it's important business data. What if we could actually do this where it could actually just replicate the things that we don't do hot up there? And so what this is doing is providing redundancy basically for everything and then only storing the hot stuff down here. I don't know if you've seen use cases for this.
Sure. Sure. So a lot of people use, or a lot of customers use the policy of least recently used data where they have that 10% or 20% of data that they use a lot, and the rest of the data they don't really use that often. So they have a need to kind of cache that most often used data, and then push the other data somewhere else. And so that's exactly what this would be used for is to push that less frequently used data to Azure Storage. And another point about this is if you have this appliance on premises in your data center and you are trying to access this data from a remote location, you can still access this data by going to Azure because it's in Azure Storage. So you can go directly to the storage and access it that way instead of going to the appliance that's on-premises.
That's a good point. You can think of it kind of like a backup device that kind of works a little bit differently. So instead of just being like some sort of tape backup mechanism, it's actually a really fast backup mechanism that allows you to cache the stuff locally that's really important to you so that your end users in the enterprise can access it really fast. Come in different sizes, right? So we can have different levels of these. If we need to cache more data because we have more users, we could put many of these devices over there, and they also come in different sizes. So you can pick the one that best fits your use case. And so that wraps the module on StorSimple.